Hey you guys, I hope y'all are doing well. I'm so excited to share this video with y'all. I've been wanting to do a classroom tour for so long. I was just waiting to get my new desk and I finally have my new desk and I'm just really happy about it. So I wanted to share everything with you guys. Before I get started, I just wanted to let y'all know I am a first year teacher. I'm teaching seventh grade math. It's been great. It's been just busy. It's been crazy, but I have loved every second of it. So I hope you guys enjoy this video and let's get to touring the classroom. This is what you see. I actually just got new desks and I'm so happy about it. And then here's this wall area too. Was just giving y'all a quick little overview of it. I love my room. Usually I have the lights off and all the lamps on just because I feel like that makes it a lot more cozy, but I don't want to spend too much time on everything. But here's the student center. This is where they can get pencils and pens, supplies, paper. I actually got this from Dollar Tree for a dollar, which is crazy. I just noticed, I don't know why I just noticed, but the H is totally worn off. So this is our appy place. And then over here, I just have like buckets. I do popsicle sticks to randomize. So there's popsicle sticks there. I got the buckets from Walmart. And then that's actually our bathroom pass because mine broke. So we've just been using that M. Here I have this really big calendar that I got from the Target Dollar Spot. And this is just like the little student center. And then my little board, You Are Capable Amazing Things. I love this little area. And then here I have my whiteboard area just in case the board ever goes out. I'm usually teaching up here. I separated it because I teach two different classes. So I have Math 7, 8 here and Math 7 over there. And I just use some really pretty washi tape. And then here I actually got these from the Target Dollar Spot for a dollar. As you can see, I still have the price on it. But these are amazing. I really like them. I would definitely recommend. And then these little cactus stickers are actually from the Dollar Tree. And I just love them. They're so cute. I am just obsessed with them. So I bordered my wall or the whiteboard and everything just because, I don't know, it added color and I thought it looked cute. My mom got me this cactus. Isn't it so cute? And I mean, my room is cactus themed, so it made sense. And then up here, I actually bought these off Teachers Pay Teachers. I'll show y'all a better view in just a second, but they're just super cute. I think they were like $3 and it came with all these different kinds of sayings, inspirational quotes, some puns, and I just love it so much. That's one of the reasons why I went with the cactus theme is because of all the fun puns that you could say. Now right here, this is just another area. Here's my Math 7 stuff. So what we do as our team is we have hand signals. So we do like sharpen pencil, bathroom. Obviously the question is the 5, and the bathroom signal has been really nice. Like when I'm teaching, they don't have to say, can I go to the bathroom? They just raise their hand and give me the 3 fingers and I know what that means. And then this has been great too. It's just like, if it's red, no cell phones. We are all under the understanding that if your cell phone is out when it's on red, I will take it up. But if it's on green, that means you can use it. And then I started this thing called the quote of the day. And someone gave me this quote. Like my students have been like, can I choose the quote next? Can I? And so I kind of write down what quotes they want and I just change it every day. So that's pretty fun. Some of them have been like relevant things to what they're actually saying. And it's just really funny to see. So that is the other side of the board. Over here, let me back up a little bit. This is like my desk area. This is my area. This area makes me really happy. I actually just changed my desk. It was more kitty corner and I changed it to sideways because I thought it would be easy to get around or like more easier to get around. So I actually thrifted this chair from Goodwill and I just love it so much. I've only sat in it like once. And I got this little cactus pillow from Hobby Lobby on sale. And I also got this little plant on sale too. I feel like it just makes the room a little bit more homey and adds some color. And it kind of hides those cords. The cords are kind of ugly. So I just love that little area. And then here's my desk area. Those stickers again are from Dollar Tree. And I just got this rug from, oh gosh, it's really dirty. I got it from, where did I get it? Like Ross or something. And then these little tassels are actually from Dollar Tree. So super duper cute. And then here's just my little desk area. These are also from Dollar Tree. I feel like Dollar Tree is just like my best friend. And then I love the amount of times students tell me that I have a lot of pins and highlighters. I'm like, yes, I know. I love them. They're so fun. So, and then one of my students actually made me this. Look how cute that is. Everyone said it's a Visco girl dog. So adorable. And then I just have lotion here. And whenever my students need lotion, they know that they can just take some. So that's my desk area. I got this on sale at Michael's and I just love the yellow. It's so cute. And then I have this big calendar, which has just saved me so much time. And then my computer and stuff like that. Back here, I have my printer and then just a bunch of letters and things my students have drawn or given me. And then someone was actually giving this away. I mean, it's not the nicest, but I really needed just an extra shelf to put like a few things on. So this was really nice to have. And then over here, I just have this window seal and it just has some plants that I was given. And then these guys are also from Dollar Tree. So that's that. Then I have this table. This is the coolest table ever. It's like a whiteboard table. I've sat with students here. I've let students work with groups here and then just work it out on the table. And it's just been so great. I keep my, so these little bins were also from the Dollar Tree and I hot glued them together. And I keep like dry erase erasers on top, some glue and some random, like a protractor. And then some Expo markers on the bottom. And this has just been really great. Students know where to come, get the Expo markers. Then here, guess where this is from? Dollar Tree. I love Dollar Tree. And I just put Crayola and crayons in here whenever we're doing like coloring projects and stuff. And then we just have calculators. Actually, one of the teachers got me calculators as a gift because I didn't have any, which was seriously the sweetest thing ever. So I just keep those supplies there. Then over here, I have my pencil sharpener. I thrifted this and I thrifted that. This was like $2 and it's seriously the best pencil sharpener ever. And then this is like my recycling bin. So over here, this is just my shelf area slash cabinet area. And I just keep like all my stuff in there. I went to Texas A&M. I'm a Dallas Cowboys fan. So I have some stuff that are relevant to me. And then I have just some funny little like jokes and sayings, and they're just really fun, and they're math related. I just love math puns, they're hilarious. That's probably the math teacher in me speaking. And then I just have like some A&M things up here, my little letter board, some markers. These bins are from Dollar Tree, look how cute they are, and I just keep random supplies in there, like scotch tape and stuff like that. Here I have some pre-algebra books, some of their workbooks. Sometimes we do like assignments through there. Then over here is my other wall. This is where I like to put their student work or anchor charts and stuff like that. I just have a lamp. It's from Walmart and I think it's only like $12 or $13, which I thought was a good deal. And then here is just an example of some student work that we've done and they just created some bar graphs. We were exploring bar graphs and stuff, so that was fun. Here we started talking about circumference and what radius and diameter is and what cutting a circle is and what it creates, and that was fun to see their reactions when we started making a circle and then it started looking more like a parallelogram and then a rectangle, so that was fun. Here, oh my gosh, you guys, if you are not sure what to put on your wall, I strongly recommend doing like a growth goals wall. So my content teacher that I student taught with did something similar to this and she does a different theme every year. And obviously I went with cactus and succulents and this was just perfect. So on each of these little cactus sticky notes, they wrote a growth goal for the year. And I said it has to be related towards school or sports or something. And a lot of them put like, my goal is to get all A's this year or something like that. So I just love this little area here. And then over here, I just have some anchor charts that I've made this year. Anchor charts are amazing, seriously. I think that it's helped my students so much. They start to memorize what is on the anchor chart. Like they memorize the location and they memorize like the formula y equals kx or 2 pi r and stuff like that. So this has just been really, really helpful. So I would strongly recommend anchor charts, especially as a math teacher. I mean, any teacher really, but as a math teacher with a lot of formulas, these have been so nice and I just make them on regular paper and then laminate them. Then over here, I love this little area. This is just like a little bookshelf that I thrifted. No one reads the books. They're there if anyone wants to borrow one or read them, but no one really touches them. But they're just there. I mean, they look cute, so. And then I just have this whiteboard that has our schedule on it, and then a little lamp. Y'all, lamps are 100% my favorite thing about classrooms. They make it so cozy. And then I just have a bunch of little random things that I got at either Dollar Tree or the thrift store I've had, so I just kind of threw them there. Oh, and then a mirror. Y'all, mirrors are great. It's crazy how many times I see my students stop by the mirror before they leave or when they get to class. Here is another one of my favorite little areas. It says math is everywhere, and on the second day of school, I just had them draw where they've seen math in the real world. Like, how is it relevant? And we talked about that. Some of them gave me little coupons, and I was like, you guys are so awesome. So the little background is actually from the Dollar Tree, which I thought was really crazy. So love that. And then here, I know that this looks kind of eh, but I thrifted all the furniture, and then like the cushions are from Walmart, and my students will randomly ask me like, can I sit there? And I'm like, yeah, sure. So I just like this little area. It's kind of fun and cute. And then here I just have this wall area. I love this little area. This part is coming off. I put tape there, but obviously it's not staying. I was not really very fond of it at first, but I like the color that it adds. There we just add current events that relate towards math. And then here's our word wall. I really want to use my word wall more often. More like, okay, let's look at the word wall. What does this mean? Kind of relate it back. So I teach two classes, so, and we're not on the same thing, so I split it up. And then right here, I just have their student center where they turn in their papers, and then they have like tape and staples and a hole punch and more lamps. Lamps are the best. I got them at the thrift store. And then I really want to get a more colorful looking tablecloth, but this one was the cheapest, so that's why I got that. And then I just have a little happy birthday sign. And then we do data. We didn't do it last week, and I have one class that their average was an 85. But basically, I like to compete with the classes and get them a prize for whoever wins. And then over here, I just have the classroom expectations. And we only have 5, and we're on the same team. So the team that I'm on, we have the same 5 expectations. So students go to class knowing what their expectations are for all of their classes. So I think that was everything. I'll give you another little overview. So I recently just got these new desks, and I just love them so much. They are so nice, and they're whiteboard friendly, so they can draw on these with Expo markers. Especially, I love that for their when they're doing their warm-ups, they can just work it out really quick. But that is my classroom. I just love my class. Cozy to me. It makes me happy. And yeah, I forgot, so I have a rug right here, and then I have some clipboards and some dry erase markers and a lost and found. If you ever want to create a lost and found in your room, I strongly suggest it, because I mean, look at it, like, students are always leaving things, and it's just nice to have them in one area where they can check. They know where my lost and found is, and they can check to see if they left anything. So again, this is my room. I love the high top tables. They're really cool. And yeah, if I miss anything, go ahead and ask, and I'll be sure to let you know if I can, where I got something, how I created it, stuff like that. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Bye.